my name is Tracy Chinwe Ifeachor, and some of you may recognise me from the hit new legal drama Show Trial on BBC One and BBC iPlayer. Now, the past 2 years have been incredibly challenging for each and every one of us. We've all lived through and experienced an incredible amount of change, not all of it negative. Focusing on some of the positive myself, I'm one of the first black women ever to lead a drama on prime time in BBC One's history. And I'm so thankful to God and so grateful to Jesus. I'm passionate about equality and sharing the love of Jesus with each and every one of you. So thank you so much for allowing us into your homes today. If you are watching this clip, it means that you have probably received one of our amazing Christmas Lunch on Jesus hampers or gift boxes. Now, as Christians and Christian churches, we have put this box together for you, and we are so blessed to have done this and to have been able to connect with you in this amazing way. So thank you for letting us into your homes and for sharing this special season with you.
Christmas is about celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ. But we understand that for so many this year, Christmas may not be as joyful as it has been in previous years. The Bible says hope is the anchor to the soul. So we hope as Christians that this Christmas Lunch on Jesus hamper helps inject a little Christmas joy back into your Christmas this season.
The boxes which were put together yesterday by a great team are being filled up with all the contents. It's carefully, delicately put on this pallet, and the pallet is then brought out of here. There's a quality control check, and then they're being put into their groups for delivery tomorrow. So it's a full-scale operation, really. It's fantastic, really well organized.
As you can see, many of the Christian churches and their congregations are literally stepping in to be the hands and feet of Jesus. We believe in showing the practical, tangible love of Jesus. So I pray you have a very Merry Christmas, and we want you to remember that Jesus is the reason for the season. Attending church can be a great source of encouragement and support to you in all seasons. You can get to know new people and discover Jesus for yourself. Simply Google a local church near you or connect with the person who brought you the Love Christmas Lunch on Jesus hamper.
Now, many of you who have received this hamper may be filled with joy, but also a little terror, thinking, what on earth do I do with this? How do I cook it? So for those of you who are not MasterChef finalists, like myself, here are some amazing cooking tips from Chef Yemi.
Hello everyone, and Merry Christmas. I'm here to demonstrate what you can create out of the Christmas Lunch on Jesus box, so you can create your Christmas dinner, and I'll give you simple tips. So the main ingredient in there is the turkey, the Christmas turkey. You need to open your turkey, wash your turkey, and pat it dry. There are various ways of seasoning the turkey, depending on what culture you come from. So people have different seasonings. My preference would be to have some butter that has been taken out. You have your butter, you have your onions, you have your curry, you have your thyme. You can have any of the seasoning. I love fresh thyme and also rosemary. So what you can do is to blend all those together, gently open the skin of your turkey and stuff it in there, underneath the skin, and make sure you spread it right across the turkey, both front and back. And when the turkey is cooking, you know, all those ingredients will melt and it will go right inside the meat. So that's for the turkey. Now for the potatoes. Potatoes, very lovely potatoes, two ways. You can either wash your potatoes, cut them and stuff them, half of them, in your turkey. Or some people prefer to peel their potato, whatever preference you like. So you can peel your potato or you wash the skin of the potato. This is 1.5 kilograms, so half of it you can stuff inside the turkey, cut your carrot, your parsnip as well. You know, cut half of it, put it inside the turkey. After you leave the turkey, to marinate for, you can do it immediately or 2 days, depending on your preference. I love a little bit of kick because it's Christmas and it's winter and it's a little bit cold. So you can add a little chili pepper to your seasoning just to give it a little bit of kick. Two ways of making my turkey. It's either you put it on the tray, you put a little water, you know, in the tray, and you put this on top of the tray and put your Christmas turkey around 3 or 4 a.m. and put your gas mark on 100 and leave it to cook slowly from the inside. It cooks slowly from the inside. And another way is just to put it whatever time some people prefer their, you know, Christmas dinner around 3 o'clock. Some people love 4 o'clock, depending on when the family will be coming around. So you can choose your time. This is a 4 kg turkey, and it will take about 3 to 4 hours to cook. The first 2 hours, once you see that your turkey is cooking, all you need to do is all the goodness that have come out of that turkey, the water and everything, just put a little on the turkey again, braise it with some olive oil and some butter, and cover it with the foil and push it back into the oven. While you are doing that, we've got a cabbage. It might be a red cabbage, so cut some red cabbage and cut some carrots, and you make it into coleslaw, depending on what you want, or you can make a little salad out of it. So I said some people prefer to put their stuffing, like the carrots, the cabbage, the parsnips, everything in the turkey. And if you don't like that method, what you can do is to cut some cabbage, cut some carrots, your parsnips, your Brussels sprout. Once the turkey is halfway cooked, then put it on the tray and allow it to steam together. So the goodness, the smell, you know, the goodness, everything cooks together and it brings out lovely Christmas turkey. So while you are waiting for your turkey, you've got lovely gum there that you can chew while you're waiting, instead of waiting forever. You've got your biscuit. Likewise, we've got mince pies in the box as well. When the turkey is almost ready, you can put it in the oven for it to be warm a little bit. I love warm mince pies. Another thing you can have is your Christmas pudding. I love it warm a little bit. Just put it in the oven and allow it to warm a little bit. So with your Christmas pudding, we've got custard in there. You can put your custard on top of your Christmas pudding, whatever method you want to use. Now, another method of making your turkey. I think about 4 years ago, I was saying to the children, we have leftover of turkey, and my children love to make sandwiches, turkey sandwich, after maybe on Boxing Day, you know? So you make your turkey sandwich, but if you don't want to roast the whole turkey, what you can do is to go to the butchers, tell the butchers to give them £1, £2, tell them to cut the turkey into little bits and pieces for you, maybe into 16 pieces, and season it with your butter, with your rosemary, with your thyme, with your curry. If you have a bit of Maggi, however you want to season it, you know, season it and add a little bit of olive oil and put everything in the tray. You know, that cooks quicker. Put everything into the tray with your potatoes, with your Brussels sprouts, with your parsnips, with your carrots. Put everything and cover the tray. That should take about half of the time that the whole turkey will cook. And if you're African like me, you can put a little bit of soya spice just to jack it up a little bit. So that's how to make your Christmas turkey. And I hope you have a wonderful Christmas this year, and God bless.
Thank you for letting us into your homes to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ through Christmas lunch on Jesus. Remember that no matter what you've done, where you've come from, where you've been, that Jesus loves you. There is no condemnation in the love of Jesus Christ.
So from Chef Yemi and myself, Tracy Ifeachor, we wish you a very Merry Christmas.